Imagine if every time you wanted someone to make a sandwich, but they had no understanding of what make a sandwich means, you'd have to describe every last step of sandwich making, from opening the fridge to slicing the bread, from layering the ingredients to spreading the condiments. If you ever needed someone to make a sandwich more than once, you'd want to agree on a common shorthand for make a sandwich. And you'd probably want make a sandwich to be generic enough to allow someone to make a ham and Swiss, or peanut butter and jelly, or tuna and sprouts. Make a sandwich becomes a new function that can take in certain inputs, such as filling, condiments, and bread, and performs a set of operations on them, spreading the condiments on bread, layering the filling between the two slices, and returns an object of type sandwich. Remember our 50 red triangles from the last stage? What if we didn't want 50 of the exact same shape, but 50 red polygons, each one with one more side than the last? First triangle, then a square, a pentagon, a hexagon, and so on. We can do just that by defining a new function that doesn't return the same shape every time. Let's call our new function myPolygon. It should take a single number for sides and return a red polygon of given sides. We can call this function with every number from 3 through 53 to fill up our screen with red polygons. At the beginning of this course, we talked about math as a kind of language. When we define variables, we are essentially adding new things or nouns into our language. When we define functions, we expand our language with new actions or verbs. In this next stage, you're going to edit and write simple functions to output a variety of images. To get inside a function, you can click the word edit in the corner of the functions block. From there, you can complete the contract for your new function, including a name, domain, and range. There's also a section for you to write a description of what your function should do. Underneath the function contract is an area for you to build your function definition. Make sure to use the parameter blocks that were generated when you filled out the domain. When you call your function, the values that you passed as inputs end up in these placeholders.